Okay, Jonas, to start off with, can you just tell me a little bit about what you were doing before you joined Evergrey?
I went to, I think it's Sweden's only high school for drummers and percussionists for 3 years. And then I got to meet Evergrey, and then I started working for them as Patrick's drum tech for about 2 years. And then he left the band and I jumped in as the new drummer.
And was the music school in Gothenburg, or
yeah.
Do you have to travel away for that?
Well, it's right outside Gothenburg, so.
And as you said, you were the drum tech for Patrick. When he left, you took over.
Yeah.
How did this transition from being the drum tech to actually being the drummer go? Was it a smooth thing for you to do, or was it quite difficult?
It was very smooth and very easy, because since I got to know the members and all the crew, and I learned how all the things worked when you were going out and do gigs and all that. So I adapted pretty quick, I think, by sitting on stage and behind the drums instead of behind the stage and watching out for Patrick. And so that it became naturally quite quick. So that felt very nice.
And you obviously knew Patrick very well, but what do you think you, as an individual and as a musician, can bring to Evergrey that maybe Patrick couldn't bring?
I think that I like to take part of the songwriting a bit more than Patrick did. That wasn't his thing. He just came in and made his drum parts, and then that was it. And he was cool about that. And that's fine, but my passion for drumming and music is bigger, so I want to take part of as much as I possibly can.
Yeah, much more involved in the song process and the recording process as well. Yeah,
exactly.
You're also the newest member of the band and also the youngest.
Yeah.
How do you feel between all these old men?
Well, I've gotten used to them. But when I first met them, I was like only 17 years old.
Yeah.
And then they felt really old. But nowadays, I don't think about it as...
You see them on as your equals?
Yeah, they're like four bigger brothers. The best bigger brothers you can have. So
yeah.
And I have them to thank for taking me on under their wings and making me their new drummer and all that. But they are old, really old.
Yeah.
I can tell you. It doesn't show on camera, but I know they are.
You know they are. It was obviously your first album that you recorded as part of the band.
Yeah.
I guess you must have learned a lot from the process of the actual recording, being involved in it. What were the biggest surprises for you? What sort of things came out that you, although you'd probably seen it from a slight detached distance, what were the biggest surprises of you?
I would say that I didn't think it would go quite as easy, and everything was so relaxed, and I don't know, everything was so easy going with the songwriting and recording and all that. On the other hand, it might depend on we recorded it in our own studio, so we had like 6 months, and we literally lived there almost.
I think you did live there almost, didn't you?
Yeah, for those 6 months, so it didn't feel like going to the studio from 9 to 5. It became almost like a home for 6 months, so that felt quite good.
And do you feel that you learned a lot that you want to bring to the next album as well?
Yeah,
yeah.
I do.
Yeah.
So,
what's your favourite? Obviously, the Inner Circle you were involved in directly, but what's your favourite of all the albums before that?
I would say Solitude, Dominance, Tragedy album.
Have you got a favourite track?
Shocking Truth. That's my favourite.
A lot of the band seems to like that.
Yeah.
It's a good
and
song. When it comes to obviously playing the drums, what were your sort of biggest influences as you were obviously studying for 2-3 years?
Yeah.
What sort of people were you thinking, I want to be like him one day.
My first influence was Ian Haugland from Europe when I was 3 years old. I saw his drum solo. He was standing in the middle of the stage with only this one snare drum and doing a quite silly thing there, a call and response thing, and I immediately wanted to be like him. So that was the first inspiration. But later on, I started listening to drummers like Mike Mangini, Terry Bozzio, Tommy Lee is a big influence, Derek Roddy, a death metal drummer from Hate Eternal, he's amazing as well. So
quite a wide range of styles then.
Yeah, well, I like all kinds of drummer. I think Frank Beard from ZZ Top is one of the greatest drummer of all, just because he doesn't do anything really. So.
I was also here. There's a little wee side project developing with you, and I think it's Henrik.
Yeah.
Can you give me a few details about that? And are there any plans to release it as an album?
Yeah, we're planning to release it. We're gonna send out some tapes to different record companies. We have recorded about 14 songs, so, and we're in a couple of weeks gonna go in and do the mixing of the album. And then we're gonna release it somewhere.
And has it got a name, and what sort of music is it?
The project is called Death Destruction, and it's heavy, raw guitar riffing and cool death metal, you can say. So.
You brought in an outside vocalist for it, or one of you singing?
We found one guy his name is Jimmy, and he's amazingly talented on that type of singing. We brought in a guy named Fredrik Larsson, who former Hammerfall bass player as well. So it's the four of us that are doing this thing.
Good. And one final question. Yeah? Somebody wanted to know a slightly unusual question. If you were a porn star, what would be your favorite position?
Since I like animals a lot, I would probably say the doggy style. Steve.